Hi, welcome to the Shtick. I'm Henry Greener, and we have with us as our special guest David Southwick MP.
Hi, Henry. How are you going?
I'm very good. Nice to see you on the bench here with me.
Thank you, Henry. Great to be here.
Yeah. What's your shtick then, David?
I'm the member for Caulfield in the State Parliament of Victoria.
And what's your speciality? What do you do?
What do I do? I have a responsibility of chair of the Education and Training Parliamentary Committee. Obviously, a lot of work in the local area of my constituents, but also a big passion in small business innovation and entrepreneurship. So for me, a big part of my life is supporting young people to ensure that they fulfil their passions and their dreams.
Because innovation these days is a very big part of our future, isn't it?
Yeah, look, when we experience so much of what we hear on the news and television about the problems of the world, for me, a lot of those solutions are in the hands of our young people and in the hands of new ideas that are coming around to fulfil those particular problems. And I look at my background as a boy attending Mount Scopus, and certainly a lot of the leadership that prompted me to enter Parliament came from those early years. But also around then, schooling was quite different, and I think in many respects a lot of that hasn't changed. We need to be really supporting our young people with life skills, and that was a big passion for me to actually get involved in politics. When I left school, I attended university, was the only person in my family to do that, and set up a cosmetics company, employed young people, giving you the short run here.
Yep.
But after doing that, then went on to do some work at RMIT, establishing an entrepreneurship program and being RMIT's first entrepreneur in residence. And for me, looking at many of those young people that didn't really fit the box, that did that entrepreneurship program, being so successful in their areas, was probably one of the most fulfilling things to see them now. And I'm on a different platform in a different stage, and looking on how we can do that in a bigger area and support more people to make a difference in our community.
Your background also is in DJing and engaging with the young community as a person who was there at every bar mitzvah and all those kids' parties. How do you think that affected your relationship with them now? Can you look back at that time?
Absolutely. And again, that's another cohort of young people that I went through many of their experiencing, many of their lives growing up. And it's a different stage to the stage that I'm playing in now. But it's all the same, you know. How do we connect with people? How do we ensure that young people are particularly supported and encouraged? And I really enjoyed those years, those early years. But I also see a lot of the problems that young people are experiencing. Things like we're in the Youth Drug and Alcohol Week too. Mm. And so how do we support many of our young people in pursuing positive, reinforceable attitudes rather than going down the road of drugs and alcohol and youth suicide and all the terrible things that we're experiencing in our society right now?
There's a show on television that I don't ever miss. It's called The Big Bang Theory.
Yes.
And it's made being a geek really fashionable and cool.
Well, it's funny you say that, because as the chair of the Education and Training Committee, we've just released a report around gifted and talented kids.
Mm.
I was talking
yes,
to you about that
right.
before. And many of those young people, which we've done the research on, have been effectively bullied. They have all the behavioural and social skills. And in fact, the young people that you would think would be the ones that would make such a difference, we've had many of those drop out at Year 10 level and just not supported. So one of our recommendations is a statewide policy to support our young people. And probably if you look at that to what's happening in Israel at the moment and how young people have been encouraged and supported at those early ages, for me, it's really an opportunity that's gone missing. And we have to ensure that those young people, like in the Big Bang Theory, are the cool kids. And
that's
the
right.
kids that are the ones that bring everybody along with them in a way that really lifts the bar. And it's just so important if we really want to invest in brain power. I think Victoria should be the state that supports brain power.
That should be the new license plate, Victoria's smart state.
Smart state, absolutely. Well, we don't have much to mine, and we don't have some of the success stories of the other states, but we do have a great education system that we can improve and support many of those young potential leaders of the future through some really good programs and encourage those to be right at the top of the bar.
It's so very important to be educated, I think, and I think that the only way that we're going to get anywhere is to educate the children in the right way, to be able to accept new technology, adapt to newer technology, and to take it to the next step, because we're only getting there at the moment.
Yeah, absolutely. And you see so many different examples of that, of young people that effectively will teach older people. And so there is this, I'm a great fan of mentoring, and I think that we need to get a lot of our great power, the people that have gone through and done so many wonderful things, mentoring our young people. But I think it's a two-way relationship. When they're mentoring the young people, then young people are also supporting them. And I have this, I suppose it's a dream, and the dream is that every young person would have a mentor, would have somebody that would support them outside of their core family.
And vice versa.
Absolutely.
It's got to work both ways.
Absolutely.
And take advantage of the great resources we have in the older people.
Correct.
Who've got experience in background in business.
Yes.
And ethics and morals, which will give a good standard and some sort of a role model. And we're going out now. We're staying with you, David. You're going to be with us for the rest of the show.
I'm looking forward to that.
Whether you like it or not.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
We're going through to a bit of talk about and also showing some videos. There is a core of videos on innovation in Israel.
Yes.
And I think that it is really important that the rest of the world take notice, because Israel does get a lot of flack and terrible press about things that, you know, related to apartheid and racism.
Sure.
And everything like that. But ultimately, Israel is really a leader in innovation.
Israel is a huge success story, and I look forward to talking a bit more about that after the break.
Thanks, David. We'll be back after the break with some Israeli innovation.